In this case, however, they were not sent for assassinations, thieving, or anything like that. No. All of those people were sent to find someone, and they've been searching for that person for over 10 years without any luck.
Okay,
you
so it can't
assume
be me.
This would cost somebody a fortune. These people have been looking for you.
Wait, how have they been looking for me for 10 years?
It seems like they were not very earnest in their search.
Okay, so I've picked up on all of this, correct?
Yes.
Alright, so I'm gonna wait for his answer.
Now that you ask him that, you see that he's a little hesitant to start talking. Well, after what happened with your parents, well, even at the time, I was a little reluctant to continue my business with them. I mostly did it for you, because I frankly wanted to spend more time with you, my dear. You were always the highlight of those dark years. Living the way we did, it's not easy. And it was catching up to me, my conscience, I mean. So, when what happened to your parents happened, a lot of things changed. There was a huge vacuum in the underworld. I believe somebody you might be familiar with, well, stepped up at that time. He looks towards you, Iris. Apparently he knows who you are. I mean, it's hard not to know you considering your family name. You would know that about that time Ruhana started organizing the underworld.
And he's been looking for me all this time, and then I just randomly pop up out of nowhere.
Yeah, exactly. Basically, he's been paying, you know, guys in the underworld to find you, but they were like, fuck it, why should we find Vira when we can just keep squeezing money out of this fucker?
Mm.
So, yeah,
completely legit business model, by the way.
Yeah, it is. It is. I'll admit that that's a very good business model, but still sad because they're exploiting Archibald. Also,
so yeah, he doesn't tell you what he spent the money on and what happened. He just said he made a few bad deals and that's that.
Mm.
Which is obviously a lie.
Yeah, a lot of bad deals looking for me, so I feel kind of sad about that.
He suddenly, you see, like a light bulb going off in his head. Ah, yes, I should have some. Yes. He starts going through his drawers. He takes out a few pieces of candy that are very nostalgic, Vira. You remember, this is the type of candy that he would bring you back when you were still with your parents. And he offers it to you.
These are... Wow.
Oh, no. Don't worry. It's not like I've been keeping them for all this time. These are fresh ones. I made sure to always have some in handy in case, you know, I get some good news. See? It's a good thing I was prepared.
She's gonna hug him. Because that's really sweet. I'm terrible. But yeah, Vera's just like really happy because somebody cared! Like,
it's a scam!
Shut the fuck up, Sibby!
Here's the problem, Po. Since you were much younger, you don't remember why. You don't know why he cares.
Yeah, well, shut the fuck up.
Turns out he's just a pervert.
Yeah, it turns out he's a pervert. Bitch, fuck you. I'm.
It turns
really
out this is Exposure inserting himself.
Wait, what?
It's an Exposure.
Yeah, an old guy that preys on little girls.
At any case, if you hug him, he also hugs you back, and you see that he's actually tearing up a little bit. He's just so happy to see you.
I'm also tearing up a little bit. I'm really happy to see him. Also, I'm distinctly aware that I have not explained why I'm so emotionally attached to this old man to anybody else. So Iris and Klein are just kind of like, is what?
I mean, this is the least weird thing that I have encountered in about a week.
When the parade was announced, I took notice of all the names. They did mention one of them is called Vira, but they gave no family name. Somewhere in the back of my head, I was hoping that it would be you, but now that I saw you in person, I still can't believe it. This must be fate, nothing else. Still, how? What happened to you after your parents' demise?
Well, it's hard to explain. You know how my parents got assassinated?
Yes, I heard all about that after the fact.
Well, it was actually the assassin that took me in.
What?
She just nods.
How?
Man, you done goof now.
I don't understand. Did he do something to you?
No, he didn't do anything. He's been very kind.
Why would he kill your parents and take you in? I don't understand.
I don't want to spill the beans that I was also trying to assassinate them, so I'm just gonna shrug.
I'm so glad Alicia's not there.
You try and steal his stuff, and I'd be
pissed.
She
would cringe so hard.
Any case, I'm sorry. I've been a bad host. I've mostly ignored you, even though you took it upon yourself to help me today. I am very sorry that I can't exactly offer you much except my gratitude at this time. But if you allow me a little time, maybe I can offer you a more sincere apology. I don't currently have any spare gold coins on me, but if you give me a few days, maybe I'll be able to scrounge something together. The guy, he just said that if you give him a few days time, he'll try to, you know, get together a small amount of money to thank you for what you did for him.
Oh, like,
no.
Vera says, whereas Vera is probably going, no, it's fine.
No, it's fine. It was a pleasure, really. I'm just happy I got to see you again.
You're so kind, dear, but you've been through so much. It's the least I can do to help you.
She shakes her head and instead gets the pouch of 50 gold coins that I was gonna slip away. I'm just gonna straight up give it to him. No, trust me. I've fallen on much better times than you have. In fact, you could do me a favor by accepting this. And I just hand him the pouch of coins.
He immediately shakes his head and closes your hand around the pouch. Please, dear. I can't accept this. I'm just an old man. I have no use for money. You will need that more than me.
Can I persuade
Denied.
Him?
Eh. You can try.
Take the money!
Now, think of this what you will, but the only way you could have persuaded him in my mind is if you roll the critical. He is not gonna accept your money.
God damn it. This is bullshit. This is bullshit. Fuck you, Esperda. You're a piece of shit.
On the help, use his contacts.
But, no, he's not accepting my money. This is bullshit. I rolled really well.
I assume you are the ones that the parade is being held for. You are the heroes, right? You should not be here. I mean, he looks towards his messy, dusty house, and obviously he feels like you don't belong in this kind of environment. Especially you, Vira. He wants better for you. But sadly, he can't offer more, so he looks a little distressed. You probably have a lot of important things to do. You shouldn't be kept up by an old man. But please, Vira, do come back, my dear. I would so much love to speak with you again.
Of course.
You can come anytime, please. Think of this as your home. I know it's not much, but I would be happy to have you back anytime.
I'll come back whenever I can.
And please, do be safe out there, alright? It's very dangerous lately. I don't want anything to happen to you.
I nod. You be careful too. Don't get hurt.
I'll be fine, don't worry. And with that, I'm assuming you guys are starting to get up and get ready to leave, so he is going to send you off.
I'm gonna add, like, 5 pieces of candy to my inventory.
Go ahead. You can have all the candy you want. It's all for you, Vera. Special Vera candy. When you consume it, it gives you +1 warm feeling inside.
Aww.
By the way, just before we go in, so you guys aren't surprised, I'm only here to make sure you're safe. That's
As
it.
You guys make your way towards the palace, you start going up the steps. On your way there, you pass through the square. You notice that there's a lot more heads on spikes. More than last time. As you go up the stairs and talk with the guards, they immediately escort you inside, and you are headed straight for the throne room where you last met the prince. It seems like his schedule is very free today. He's been waiting, especially for you. Despite him apparently having no way of knowing that you would be here right this day, right now.
How weird.
So he's just been sitting in his throne room alone, waiting for us to come in like a fucking loser.
Well, I mean, chances are someone just told him we were coming up. It is a castle.
Yep.
We weren't exactly conspicuous.
We didn't sneak in, did we?
Nope.
Of course
you
didn't.
By the way, Alyssia, about you sneaking, are you with the group now, or...?
Oh, no. Just briefly to explain, like, what she wants to do is get a lay of the land, like, when it comes to the underground. Considering, like, the influx of refugees in her mind means, oh, there's going to be gang activity and, like, a sharp increase in criminality, you know, in crime
gang
and organized crime,
and
you know.
Crime is through the roof.
Oh, yeah.
Why we don't accept refugees.
So she
right now, Alyssia, if you decide to mug somebody in the main streets, there's a 50-50 chance that no guard will come and no guard will notice. That's how bad it is.
And there's like a 80% chance that no fucks will be given.
Exactly.
but like her in her mind, like this is pretty much like, you know, means that like there should be a sharp rise in organized crime because there's no organization from the government.
Yeah, it's pretty bad. So, as you can imagine, here's the problem, though. All the refugees causing crimes, they're not part of the organizations that used to run the city. So, the organized crime syndicates are kind of having their own little war against the refugees.
Oh, I know. Basically, she wants to, like, hit up some old contacts and, like, figure out what the fuck the power situation between the crime families actually look like.
Gotcha. You can do that. We'll do that as soon as we get this next
part
out of
that for?
The way. Right.
That's cool.
As you guys make your way towards the throne room, you are stopped with a few by a few guards right in front. Just a sec. The people escorting you stop you in front of the main door leading to the prince. And Klein, they get right into your face. Not you. You're coming with us.
He's
I just
my bodyguard.
Look down at them. Look to the rest of the group. Raise an eyebrow.
He's my bodyguard.
No,
why
Vince,
isn't he
inside?
I'm here to make sure they're safe.
The guard
you can either step
you
out
again.
Of our way,
no, Vince,
or you can tell
allow.
Your master to come out here.
Fine. Maybe you should just wait by the door.
You should listen to your friend. Ovian pig.
I nut him.
She's gonna go, why does everybody with a suit of armor or major, like muscles have to be...
I'm assuming by nut him you mean that you're gonna kick him in the balls?
No, I mean I slam my forehead into his nose.
Roll me damage.
Sure.
She's just rubbing her face, it's like...
I was gonna let it go until he added that last little insult.
We're gonna have to walk through this door with three knocked out guards, aren't we?
You slam hard into him. His helmet protects him for the most part, but you see droplets of blood. You definitely at least jacked his nose pretty good through the helmet as he recoils back.
Say that again, and I use the blade.
You shouldn't have done that. You see the guy is pretty angry as he starts raising his weapon. However, the other knights stop him. You think you're such a tough man? Let's step outside.
I just roll my shoulder a bit, flex, look over, lean the halberd against the wall, and just start cracking knuckles.
The guy that you just, well, greeted in a more, shall we say, manly manner, flanked by two other knights, start leading you outside. The rest of the escort just continue on with their duty and usher the rest of the party inside. However, before you're let in, it seems that the prince is in the middle of a very heated conversation with someone, so they stop you. You, however, manage to listen in on the tail end of the conversation going on inside. This is what you manage to hear. From what you can see, the two people inside are the prince and his royal advisor who are speaking. Please come to your senses, my prince. This madness cannot continue. We risk famine, pollution, and overpopulation, increasing crimes, race wars. And worst of all, we are losing the support of the Ovian Empire and the other kingdoms. We must close our borders before it's too late. Your people are suffering. My people are those who bend their knee. I care not for their place of birth, social status, or history. My love is equal for them all. We will take every refugee who wishes to come here. And how long can this go on? Our kingdom is small, and yet our population in the last few months has nearly doubled. We are headed for a crisis that will destroy the kingdom. I beg you, my prince, you have to reconsider. Close our borders. Let us take the Oven Empire to the negotiation table. They will surely listen and extend the helping hand as they always have. They will surely help us with this refugee disaster. And if not, then help us drive them off with force and relocate them somewhere else where they can settle down. We must serve justice for the people of Edelwand who are being oppressed by all of this. But a perfectly logical and reasonable argument, Berboros. But remember well this one thing. If you use force to serve justice, no one is going to follow your idealistic scenario. No one is going to agree to that. My prince, I have served you faithfully all these years. I was your caretaker, but this is simply unreasonable. We gain nothing by helping these people. We walk together with the weak. You walk together with the weak, accept the weak, and give strength to the weak, if only for an instant. That's why you are strong, but in the end, you can't save anyone, and you don't want to save anyone anyway. You've made a kingdom that was created just to be destroyed. I've heard enough. You are dismissed. You are right about one thing, Berboros. You have served me for a long time. With my coronation coming up soon, I will no longer have need of your services. Rejoice! Your long service is nearly at an end, and you can start considering your retirement. You hear the prince chuckle from the inside as the royal advisor starts storming out of the room, incredibly angry. He notices you guys and glares daggers at you as he leaves without a word. And then you are ushered inside the throne room.
Okay.
It's the familiar throne room that you saw last time you were here. Nothing has changed. Well, the throne room hasn't changed. However, the prince, the person in the throne, it seems like he has changed a lot during the last 6 months. This is what you remember. But this is what you see in the throne when you look up now.
God damn.
Ah yes, you're finally here. He says as you guys walk into the throne room. About time you've made me wait for so long. Tell me, how was your 6 month vacation like? Did you enjoy it?
Very cold. That's really all I could say about it. Rude awakening as well.
Such is life. but that's what makes it interesting. Without hardships, what's the point? I believe you brought the Novian dog to my doorstep. Do you mind telling me why?
He is a friend. Helped us when we were...
Please, he's a friend. Obviously just a spy sent to keep an eye on you.
She shrugs. Well, King, he's not the only one that sends them. If people wish to see what we do, and it gives them hope, I see no reason to deny them.
I am not king yet, my dear. But all in due time, after your parade, it's my time to ascend to the throne.
The parade. I was rather shocked to hear that one was even being made.
What are you now? How so?
Well, after 6 months in a cold embrace, suddenly knowing that you have a parade waiting for you, because somebody had precognition.
I believe such an event is quite fitting for one such as yourself. After all, not many can say they can survive a meeting with the enemy. The Overworld, was it not? Quite impressive. Not only that, but you have distinguished yourselves on the front lines already in the short time you spent there. Despite, shall we say, abandoning your duties halfway. But I can overlook that little detail for you. I am a generous ruler after all. I value results, not unnecessary things like betrayal.
I am glad.
Interesting. You seem quite similar to last time I saw you. I guess spending 6 months in ice would do that to a person. The world has moved on and left you behind, but you remain the same. There's something quite romantic to it, if you think about it.
Well, being 6 months younger in an older world has its perks.
So tell me, what do you think now that the world has moved on?
I fear for it. It's been left in a sorry state.
I would agree. After all, the demons have taken more of our lands, and the people are quite desperate for somebody to help them.
Well, I guess I could fill that void. Noble Moon is a company of war, and we will fight again.
My, how very honorable of you. I would expect no less from the heroes of Edelwand. And you will have my full support going forward as you continue to achieve great feats in my name.
Ah, but my king, achieve these feats in my name. In our name.
You are my subject. All of your achievements are mine.
She's just gonna smile. That's an interesting way to think of it.
What you do with my blessing, and you will do with my full support. Have I made myself clear?
If you wish to think that, my king, it will probably boost morale, isn't that?
Let's not waste time with this boring topic. We can work out the finer details later. None of this is important anyway. What is important is your parade. You are the guests of honor after all. and you must look the part. Even you, girl. She looks towards you, Vira, by the way. As much as you'd like to stay out of sight and continue to stay silent, that is not going to be allowed anymore.
Okay, first of all, bitch, I didn't have anything to fucking say, so come here. Okay. I'm just gonna shrug. I just shrug.
You'd think that somebody with your past would be more open-minded, but I see you're quite reclusive. Disappointing. Your parents were much more of a go-getter type of person, the type of people.
Well, I'm glad I'm not like them.
Really now? You think your parents were in the wrong for what they were doing?
Yes.
Well, I'm very happy to hear you say that, my dear. After all, it is people like your parents that now, shall we say, decorate my city square.
I am aware.
Now, considering your, shall we say, peculiar situation, raise your head with no worries. I will not punish you for the crimes of your family. After all, those are crimes not committed by you. You are just another citizen like anybody else here, and I extend my full understanding and love towards you, as I do for all of them. You do not need to worry, your head will not join the others.
Thank you, I appreciate that.
Oh, do not thank me yet, my dear. I believe your parents left quite the fortune in their wake. And I believe that as the rightful heir, that belongs to you.
Huh.
What do you mean by that exactly?
Read between the lines, my dear. Your family fortune is yours. I am currently in possession of it, but you may have it back.
I appreciate that.
My, we are so grateful and so talkative all of a sudden.
I don't get the sense that Vera is just zero fucks given.
So, I believe we're missing other people as well. In particularly that savage dog. Why did you not bring him back?
Oh, he has returned to his homeland.
How boring. But whatever. There is somebody else missing, but she is of no interest to me. I believe the important people were here. And by that I mean just you, Iris. Since you are dense and can't read between the lines, my offer to you still stands, just so you are aware.
I mentioned before that I would find out about my heiress status. Sadly, being frozen in ice for 6 months kind of delayed prospect.
It hardly matters anyway. Just know that my patience is not limitless. I suggest you make a decision soon. Every king needs a queen, after all.
What? Hey! What? Twice?
You got two next.